In this video, I will show you how to do the initial configuration for free NAS, and such as adding a new pool and setting up a share window SMP shares, and discuss the reason why I chose to use the window SMP. Okay, go ahead and log in. The default username for FreeNAS is the root, and the password whatever that you create when you install it. Alright, so now we're in. This is a FreeNAS 11.42 release stable versions. Let's go to storage. And pool. Right now, you see I have no pool. I'm going ahead and add it, and we can create a new pool. Name, I'm gonna call it share drive. And encryption. Right here, say. Encryption is if you have sensitive data, you might want to turn on encryption and hit confirm. And the quickie will hit on the suggest layout, and it automatically suggests this for my pool SIG disk, three terabyte each. And it automatically suggests is RAID Z2. The minimum disk required for Z2 is 5 disks, and the minimum required for Z3 is 8 disks. Right now I only have 6, so it's automatically recommended Z2. So I ran my FreeNAS on the Dell R720XD. It have 12 bays, 345 inch hard drive, and 245 in the back. So I'm gonna have two pool, one pool with 6 hard drive each. Alright, everything good to go. We're gonna hit on re-8 and confirm. And this is gonna take a moment. All right. So it lets you know that you need to back up your key, encrypted key. If you lost this key, and you try to detach your pool and then reattaches, and you don't have the key, then no way that you can mail it. So go ahead and download the key. I'm just gonna keep it in my document for now. Gonna name it Dell R720XT Pool 1. Alright, so now that we have a key, make sure that you have a multiple backup, and do not put it on the pool itself, because when you unmail it, then no way you can access it. Here we go. Okay, so now we got a share drive. Let's create some account. Okay, I'm gonna create a new account. So my name and username for the window SMP shares, it or even the what is it called? AFP, the Apple shares. It case sensitive, so the best way is just leave the username as lower K. And set up a password for it. And if you want to create a new primary groups, you're gonna check that box. If not, then you just leave it. I'm not creating any group right now, so I'm just gonna check it out. And we're gonna leave everything as default, except for I'm gonna check it for permiss sudo and Microsoft account. Okay, it want me to create a group anyway, huh? Okay, we're just gonna put it in the root for right now. I'm gonna put in media. And there you go. Now that we have a user account, the next step is setting up permissions. I'm gonna go back to a pool. And let's go edit options. Make sure to set tab with Unix. It works great for both Windows and Macs. And we're gonna edit permissions. Leave as at default. And right here, the username, we're gonna change it to the one we just created. And we're gonna hit save. Alright. Next, we're gonna create a window SMP share. Okay, here we go. Add patch. Hit on the folder icon. Share drive. We're gonna mail it to the share drive. And we're gonna name it ShareDrive. Just level K and then save it. And we're gonna enable the service by default. If you go to services, it not automatically enable. So when the FreeNAS 1142 actually very smart, when you start the SMP service, it automatically start the SMP and set it to automatic start with the FreeNAS OS. All right, now that we have the share window SMP mount point, I'm gonna show you how to mail it, map a share try in window. So in window, we're gonna actually, you're not gonna open up anything. On the window, on the keyboard, you hit the window logo and the R key to open up the run, and you're gonna tap in there. The IP backslash and the IP address of your FreeNAS, and you hit enter, and here's open up the share drive. Sorry, it's popping up in my second monitor, and you double click on it. It's running. So what I do right now, it actually query the FreeNAS, and the FreeNAS gonna say, hey, only these users authorized to access the share trial. Here you go. So it asking you for credentials, which is the username that we created earlier in the freenet box, and password. And you're gonna hit on remember my credentials. So the next time that let's say you reboot the window, or the next time you access the share trial, you don't have to type in the password. Window automatically put in the credential for you, and hit OK. And that is, we're able to access the share trial. So in order to map the share trial, I'm gonna go back one tab and right click on this one, and it's right here. It say map your network trial. Normally a network trial will leave as Z, but you can map it to whatever trial you want. And you hit finish, and there you go. Yeah, you have a share trial on Windows PC. And I'm gonna step over to my MacBook, and I'll show you how to mail the SMB share trial on the MacBook. But before that, let's test the share trial by copying one of the video file and see how fat it is. I got a bunch of YouTube video tutorial right here, so I'm just gonna pick one of it and drag it over and see how fast it is. That's pretty good. Let me pick a bigger file and try it. Alright, let me see how big is this file. Alright, perfect. This one is almost 2 GB. Let's test it out. So because I'm connected to my router wirelessly, it's not gonna get any faster than it did. If you connect it with the Ethernet wire to your router or switch, you're gonna be much faster, but this is as much as you can get. It varies. Sometimes it's 20 megabits per second, sometimes I can go up to 50 megabits per second, and that pretty much it. Let me step over to my Mac and I'll show you how to map the SMP sharing. Actually, there one more thing before I head over to my Mac computer, my Mac computers. Normally at before that I tested it at 50 megabits per second, but now it dropped in half. So when you re-add a window SMP shares, it kind of automatically change the share tab in the home pool to window. And you're gonna go in there and change it to Unix. And for the commands, certain device such as printer, for some reason it kinda like to have commands on it. So we're just gonna put in a share drive. Alright, and let me show you again. We're gonna test this copy in another video, see if the speed actually pick it up. Let me see how big the video. Too small, not a lot. There you go, that's perfect. And you see right here, the speed actually a little bit faster than the last one. Let me check my my wireless signal is kind of weak right now, but you can see it actually faster than that when it's set to window. All right, that's it for chit chat. Let me go back to my Mac and show you how to mount it on the Mac OS. All right, guys. So now I'm on my Mac. I'll show you how to mount the SMP on Mac. So from the you click anywhere on the desktop, it's gonna go to the default folder. You go to Go. And you hit on connect to a server, so it's gonna be SMP column, then to backslash, and then the IP address of your NAS all free NAS servers, and hit connect. Oops, looks like I might put it wrong. Oh, there you go. So SMB flash, not backflash. And connect. So I ask for you for the user. So the same user that we created or you created earlier. And we're gonna remember this in keychain so that you don't have to tap it in every time you connect it to their shared drive or the FreeNAS servers. And it's mounting the shared drive. And here this guy, you can see all the file that I copied it earlier on the Windows computer. There it is, and that's it for the tutorial, guy. And actually, it automatically mounted here now, FreeNAS, and you can access this from here also. So that's it. I'll see you guys in the next tutorial. Bye.